Hello and welcome to Take a Bite. Today I'm showing you a soybean chakli, three versions of it, that is fried, baked and soy stick with the spice mix. And these are very nutritious and very good for the people who have the gluten allergy, because these are the gluten free chaklis. So let's see what we will need. Here we will need 1 cup of soybean flour, 1/2 a cup of UDAD DAAL flour, 1/2 a cup of rice flour, 3 tablespoons of oil, warm water, and here I have taken some spices. So here I have taken the CAROM seeds, sesame seed, black salt, normal salt as per your taste, and 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder and some baking soda. And this is the spice mix which will go on the soy stick and as well as on the chutney. So detail of the each of the ingredient will be listed down in the description box below, so do check it out for the exact measurements. So we will sprinkle this masala on the soy stick as well as on the chaklis. Now we will make the dough in the big bowl, adding all the flours, that is the soybean flour, which is high in protein and it is totally gluten free. Adding UDAD DAAL. UDAD DAAL in itself is gluten free, and the rice flour, it is also gluten free, so it makes the perfect crunchy dish for the people who have the gluten allergy. Adding some oil, and we will knead this dough with the warm water. So we have to knead the dough, which should not be too tight nor too soft. Adding little by little water, and we have to knead the dough, and now we will keep this dough aside for 20 minutes, and after 20 minutes we will sprinkle some oil and we will knead the dough again and make it a smooth dough. Now taking a muraku maker or chakli maker, here I am using the star shaped nozzle for making the chaklis. Now we have to grease this with a little bit of oil so that it cannot stick inside. And now taking a small portion from it and putting inside. Close the lid and we will start making the chaklis. And we will make the chaklis like this in the clockwise manner. Round shape like this, and we will make all the chaklis in the same manner. And now let's make the fried chaklis first. So here I have heated some oil, and if we drop some ball or the portion from the mixture, it should come up, and that is the time when you know your oil is hot enough. So adding some chaklis inside, and when you drop your chaklis inside, the temperature should be at low, and you have to fry them at low medium speed. Now we will fry the chaklis till they become golden brown, and we have to flip them and fry from both the sides. And now they have taken beautiful golden brown color, so they are ready to take out, and we will take them out on the kitchen towel and the tissue paper so that excess oil will be absorbed. And we will fry the next batch of chakli. Here you have to keep in mind the one most important thing: when you are dropping your chaklis, the flame of your gas should be at low, and you can turn them now and fry them in the same manner as we did. And here now I am mixing all the masalas which will go on the chakli. Once they are hot enough, you have to sprinkle at that time only. So now we will sprinkle it, and let's make the baked chaklis. For that I have already preheated the oven at 325 Fahrenheit, and now we have to make the chaklis in the same manner. And now we will brush it with little bit of oil. If you want to avoid this tape, you can surely avoid it, but it gives a nice golden color. And now we have already preheated the oven and putting the tray inside, and we have to flip it after every 10 minutes. And now they are done from both the sides. I have flipped in between and they are done from both the sides. And once they are hot enough, I will sprinkle the masala so that it can stick it very well to it. And from both the sides we have to sprinkle the generous amount of masala. So our baked chaklis are now ready. They are so delicious and very healthy also. So now let's make the soy stick. For that, just you have to make a long strip like this, and you have to fry them, and you have to fry them as we did for the fried chaklis. And again we will sprinkle the spice mix or the masala mix which we have made. Once they are hot enough, we will sprinkle the masala so the masala will stick to the soy stick properly. We will break them, and now we will sprinkle the masala all over. Now we have to sprinkle the masala generously and we will mix it nicely. So our soy sticks are also ready. So do try this recipe at home. These are super delicious, and if you want the healthy option, you can opt for the baked ones. So thank you so much for watching. And if you like this video, hit that like button and subscribe to Take a Bite. Thank you so much. Stay tuned, stay hungry.